Hey Yugi-Tubers, it's me, Nthny4, course 117. I'm cool too, uploading on my friend BlueEyesDemonDragon, also who's a friend of the 6 Samurai one. Today I'm going to be showing you guys my ice barrier complete. 16 monsters, 13 spells, and 11 traps. This is kind of like an OCG style deck where I'm more depending on my traps mostly than my monsters. Extra deck here, tokens. I wish I had a super of that, but oh well. And last but not least, the side deck. So I'm gonna quickly go over the deck with you guys. Two general Gantalas, which is a once per turn during your end phase you can bring back an iceberry monster. This is kind of helpful for bringing out a defender, cryo, strategist, or a samurai. Most presumably, if you want to be bold, you would synchro into these two, into eights. So it's a 27 beater, but it's quite heavily useful. One Royal Knight of the Ice Barrier. It's a bad monarch, but I mostly use it for the ditch fodder. You know, strategist, ditch it, draw a card. And when I have double Gantalas, I'm going to crank out these guys to get for, like I said earlier, I can go for eights, sevens, or nines. But you're going to have to figure out how I'm going to get the nine with this since I know it. Dance Princess is, Dance Princess is while you control another Ice Bearer, presumably you want to have Cryo or Defender, and you can reveal any number of Ice Bearer, most presumably 3 or 4, to balance your opponent's face down spell or traps. So it's good for handling your opponent's Solemn Warnings, their Bottomless, their Crevice, or, well, not the Crevice, but most presumably you would get their bigger high-end cards like Mirror Force or Solemn Warning. Samurai of the Ice Bear is the beater of the deck. If you put this card in defense mode, he automatically commits suicide and you draw a card, which is useful. And if you have the double General Gantala, you can abuse it to the full extent. Special in attack, main phase, switch it to defense, kill itself. Strategist is really the major draw power of the deck, because without it, you can't really combo into everything. And in this version, you have a lot of cards to dump. And with the vast majority of draw power in this deck, you can cycle through your deck, and you will never top deck. Shock Tripper is once you could tribute this guy to kill any number of water monsters. Presumably, you can kill your monsters, but if your opponent has a Trishula or a Brionic, just summon him, kill it, and get it over with. And then you search whatever Ice Bear you need, so it's useful. Defender is a one-sided gravity bond. If your opponent controls... if you control another Ice Bear, monsters with equal to or less to, higher than this card's defense, which is 16, cannot declare an attack. So I mostly just use it for sixes. I can go into combos of 7 if I presumably wanted, or if I go for the 9. Just to tell you guys, 1 Royal, 2 Dance, 2 Samurai, 2 Strata, 1 Shark, 2 Defender, 1 Cryo. Cryomaster is pretty standard. I run 1 instead of 2. People run 2, I run 1. So it's really a judgment, because I run this guy as the main fodder for most level 6, but I have another out if I need to. It's useful to an extent, but I like it because it's a gravity bond. Caravan, because you're going to ditch most of your ice barriers, you most likely will recycle your Trishula, your level 4s most similarly because you have duplicates. You could also recycle Defender if you wanted to, if you want to be bold. A major draw power of the deck is 1 Morphing Jar. Without the Morphing Jar, you can't really combo into everything. But in a way, it also signifies that you're going to go for that game. And you could recycle your hand, go into Gungnir, bust on your opponent's front door, and smash him with a Morphing Jar. 2 Secret Village. Surprisingly, you're going to say, why do you run this if you run so little? Because I have only 5 Spellcasters, but I have so much draw power, it's kind of easy to draw into this to establish your dominance over your opponent, as well as the control aspect, which is this deck is called Frozen Courtyard. You have that, along with several other cards I'll go through. 2 more greed, it's standard. 3 medallions, standard. 2 magic, people run 3 or 1, I don't know, actually, 3 or 2. I run 2 because I don't have so much monsters and I'm not so dependent on it, just for a little. 2 mysticals, but when you synchro, you don't want to use your mysticals anymore. You just want to crank them out. Use Gungnir, bash them in the face with it. Giant Trunade, staple. All this stuff, staple. Compulsory, Dimensional, Mirror Force, Solemn, Skill Drain, and Tyrant. And the Synchronous itself, one Brionic, two Gungnir, one Trishula, Delorn. Delorn is simply magnifique in this build because you can recycle Call on Haunted, Tyrant, or Secret Village, and then you can get this guy up to at least 4,000 at most. The extra deck is, as you guys can see, Standards, AOJ, Decisive Amoa, Cataster, Chimera Tech, Armory Arm, Thought Ruler, Colossal, Black Rose, Red Dragon Archery, and 2 Stardust. The side deck, this one here is going to actually be going in a major overhaul, because I'm just going to, anything you see here is going to be removed permanently from this deck. But overall, Wicked Avatar, DD Crow, Dai Soho, Geomancer, Secret Guard. There's actually an interesting tech choice, but I'm going to tell you guys why I use this guy in the side deck. 2 Effect Veilers, 1 Medium, 2 Crevice, 2 Bottomless, Spellbreaker, Raiho, and Warlock. The reason why I see Secret Guard as a side deck card is because in my variant, your opponent's most likely not going to hit you with Ackles until they can establish their combos. And not only that, you have Secret Village, you have Compulsories, you have every in and out against a Dragon any player. The only time is they'll get you is if they go first, they smash you with their combos, and you can't come back from that. But most likely in this variant, you can see that I can cover my ins and outs of every aspect. Sure, I don't have the other generals or the other core parts of the deck, but this is really what I think is the core. You only need 2 strategists. Caravan's not necessary, but I think it is, because without it, you'll be losing a lot of fuel, and you can't even use your Trishula anymore once it's gone. You'll be like, oh, I can synchro for Trishula? Bottomless? Aww. But no. I'm going to just explain to you guys the core aspect of this deck, which is locking your opponent's spell, sealing your monster's in-game effects, on-field effects, and making sure you don't get screwed over with their traps, such as Bottomless, Royal, Divine Wrath, all that. You just hit them where it hurts. And surely enough, you don't have the biggest beaters, but that all goes into your synchros, because you can establish a battle lock, a spell lock, a trap lock, and a monster lock. With those locks, you're able to dictate what your opponent plays, along with how they correlate in the duel. So as you guys can see, I'm just going to show you guys the quick deck over again. Hope you guys can see that, because I'm just using my new camera now. Tokens. If you guys have suggestions for the side deck, please tell me so I can change it. But as you guys can see, the only 3 cards I'm going to take is just those 3. Other than that, I'm going to keep it as it is. And once again, I hope I want to say thank you for BlueEyesDemonDragon for allowing me to upload my hidden dual terminal deck on his channel. While his dual terminal deck or hidden arsenal deck is Dragonity, so I'm going to annotate that right here. I'm going to post the deck list below. Please comment, rate, and subscribe to Nthny4, which is going to be right there. So tell me what you guys think of the deck list. Tell me what you guys, the overall feel. And if you have questions or things to say, I'll accept them and figure out what to do or change it. And if you have something to say about this deck, I'll gladly speak with you over a comment or a PM. So once again, YouTubers, Nthny4 signing out on Blue Eyes Demon Dragon. Take care, guys. Rock on hard and study well. Nthny4 signing out with a Trishula removing you guys from play.